Friends, welcome to Easy and Home Style Cooking. I'm Mrs. Ragini. Today, I'm going to share a baking recipe. This sponge cake, we are going to make it with mango pulp. I already showed you a couple of recipes with mango pulp. Try those. They are very, very simple to make and nice. So today, for this sponge cake, first we need butter. We are going to take 30 grams of butter and 2 tablespoons of sugar, or 20 grams of powdered sugar or regular sugar you can take. So today I'm using powdered sugar. First we are going to cream this, and for this we are using half a cup of all-purpose flour. If you want to increase, what you can do is take 1 cup of flour and you can use 1 egg. So I'm just using half. Beat the egg and use half of the egg. Now mix it, and we are going to add the pulp also. Pulp, you can take half a cup of pulp, mango pulp. Mix this also. Once you mix the pulp also, you can add the vanilla essence just for flavor. If you want, you can use mango essence, you know, for mango flavor. And once you mix this, now we are going to mix the flours. So here I have the half cup of all-purpose flour. Today I am using 1 or 2 tablespoons of regular, that is the wheat flour also. So if you want, you can use, or you can increase the all-purpose flour quantity. Here is the baking soda, pinch, and baking powder, pinch, and 1 tablespoon of wheat flour, and 1 tablespoon of suji, that is semolina. And we are going to also add some choco chips. If you want, you can add, it's an optional, or you can add dry fruits also. We are going to mix this once. So friends, here you can see I have mixed this, and now we are going to add this flour mixture into our egg mixture. You can use a spatula or you can use a whisk also. The same mixture, you can use it in muffin molds also. You can make small muffins. Mix this. So friends, here you can see I have mixed this nicely, and we are going to remove this. As I told you, the same mixture you can use for cupcake molds also. Today I am using a round baking tin. And here is the tin. I greased it with some butter. You can also grease it with little bit butter. If you have a silicone, you need not. And now we are going to pour this mixture into this tray. This will spread automatically, so don't worry. So friends, here I arranged it. Now we are going to bake this at 180 degrees centigrade for 15 to 20 minutes, or till your cake is done. So I'm going to put this in oven, and we are going to meet after 15 or 20 minutes. Dear friends, after 20 minutes you can see our mango cake, that is a tea time cake with nice choco chips, are all ready. Now what you can do is, I have already rested this for some time, because tea time cakes, you cannot cut it immediately. We need to rest this for some time so that you can cut easily. And you can see nice crust outside, and inside it is little bit soft. And you can cut it in whichever way you want. Usually, if you want, you can cut it in bread slices or some triangles. And the chocolate is nicely melted, and we are getting a chocolates in between. Isn't it nice? See, it's not too soft, but it's like a bread. That's what, it's tea time cake. So just take a cup of coffee and have this cake, and your morning breakfast will be full. So friends, here is our tea cake. I cut it into nice triangle. You can cut it into lengths also. This won't be, you know, too sweet, because we added very little of sugar, because it's a tea time cake. But in between we are getting the choco chips. Those gives a nice sweetie texture, and little bit of suji we added. In between I'm getting the crunchy effect. This is super, dear friends. You need to try this summer. Use the mango pulp, or you can use strawberry, and you can make this simple tea time cake. I hope you enjoyed this.